Old 450. Oh, this brings back memories. Low range feels. This has got Kenda Executioners on it. So, good shout out to you, Rob. These are awesome tires, by the way. Got them for like 240 on eBay. What the guy said. Handles a lot better than mine. What am I doing? Yeah, this thing feels good though. This thing feels good though.
Yeah, it does alright for a 450.
Yeah, for some reason it just feels a lot more stable.
You think so?
Yeah, I don't know what about it feels so good, but it just feels more stable, like it's more of a trail bike.
Yeah.
Since I guess that's considered more of a mud bike.
Oh yeah.
So.
What year is this?
19. Yeah, and this is pretty nice too, I won't lie. I like it.
Yeah.
Alright, round two. Seems like this guy's got a, I talked to him earlier, and he's got a custom speaker set up, which is really nice. I don't know how much he said he put into it. I think he put like 40 bucks or something into it. It's like a case dash speaker dash car radio, which is right here, and his in tank is right there. It's really cool, actually, the way he's got it set up. This thing's got some pretty good traction. These Can-Am Executioners, I think they're 25 by 9 by 12 in the front, and 25 by, I think 11 by 12 in the rear. They might be by 10 though. Man, this thing brings back a lot of memories. Painful memories and stupid things that I said that I shouldn't have said. His shocks preset like one notch above mine, which mine is one notch away from fully soft. It's probably what makes it so tippy. it does kind of remind me of my old 450, even though that thing broke down every single ride. But to be fair, I didn't really do a good job of taking care of that thing, and you all know that. Well, those who have been around since I've had it. In terms of the tires, I think the tires are pretty good. Don't grip quite as well as the Mega Mayhems do, but they're still good nonetheless.